There's been a lot of changes when it comes to electrical. There's been a lot of things that have happened in ESA, in Electrical Safety Authority, along the way, and even to the point where it became the very first trade that was that you could be fined for not following procedure, not getting permits, playing with electrical when you're not licensed to. Mm-hmm. So let's, I want to talk a lot about this today, and sure. I want to get into, let's just start it right out. Homeowners out there, you need to know this. When do you need a permit?
Very simple answer. Anytime wire comes out of my truck, I need a permit. It's clearly that easy. If I'm changing a receptacle, I'm changing a switch, do I need a permit? For me, as a contractor, the answer is no, as long as I'm not altering a circuit. The minute that a circuit's being altered, so I'm adding wire to the circuit, running a brand new one, you need a permit. It's that simple. If you're working with aluminum wiring, the electrical code says that if you have aluminum wiring and you're a homeowner, you decide to change your own switch, you need a permit. I don't as a contractor, you as a homeowner do.
You need to be a licensed electrical contractor to even pull a permit, correct?
That's correct. So there is a lot of misunderstanding on, you know, what the duties are of a licensed electrical contractor, an electrician, a master electrician. Three totally different things that a lot of people seem to confuse. A master electrician is simply someone that understands the business side. And I'm speaking in layman's terms, keeping it very, very simple for everyone that's watching. A master electrician is needed in order for an electrical contracting company in order to conduct business. What's an electrician? An electrician is someone that is allowed to do work for a licensed electrical contractor. So when you have an electrician that comes to your door, knocks on the door and says, hey, I'm an electrician. Well, that's great. They're not allowed to work directly for you. They're allowed to work for an electrical contractor, not for a homeowner. So the only person that's allowed to work for a homeowner is a licensed electrical contractor. Master license compared to an electrical license. Is one better than the other? Well, again, no. A master electrician is someone that understands the business side of it, and they are employed by an electrical contracting company in order to help run that company within the letter of the law.
Okay, but a master electrician also means that you've gone to school completely to the limit for industrial, for residential. You cover all aspects of electrical, correct?
Yes and no.
Okay, explain it.
All right, so the master electrician gives me business courses that I need to know. I need to know what, if one of my employees has any questions that end up arising when it comes to Employment Standards Act, I have to know the answers. Employment insurance, I have to have the answers. That's the business side that they teach us when we write our master's license. So our master's license doesn't make me a better electrician. It just means that I can assist an electrical contractor in order to run their business within the law.
So let's just say, what exactly should any homeowner ask a licensed electrician and or LEC, a licensed electrical contractor? What are the questions they need to ask? Hey, Frank, my name's Mike.
Okay, Mike.
What do I need to know about you coming into my house?
You need to know that the person that's coming into your home, if they're there to quote the job, so you just have a salesperson knocking on your door, or it's an actual electrician knocking on your door, the two questions you need to ask is, who's the electrical contractor that you represent? Really simple. It's the electrical contractor that is going to be filing the paperwork with the Electrical Safety Authority to make sure that your job is going to comply to the Ontario Electrical Code.